I remember that winter because it brought the heaviest snow that I had ever seen. Snow had fallen steadily all night long, and in the morning I woke in a room filled with light and silence. The whole world seemed to be held in a dreamlike stillness. It was a magical day, and it was on that day I made the snowman.
Christmas specials, whether they be on television or home video, have always been a staple of the season, but what are some of your favorites?
We have televised material like Rudolph and Frosty, holiday episodes of TV shows and cartoons, and many, many films that are watched throughout the season, but today I want to share a little television special from Britain that you just might not be familiar with. So anyway, here's The Snowman. Produced by Britain's own Channel 4 in 1982 and based off of the book of the same name by Raymond Briggs, The Snowman is a half-hour Christmas special that does have a following but largely remains unknown by most people, which is a shame because, while acknowledging its faults, I think it's not only a strong special for the Christmas season, but one of the most unique pieces of animation to ever come out of the jolly good country. Some of you might have been fortunate enough to own a VHS copy of the film or have caught a glimpse of it on television, but unfortunately it just falls short of being in the mass public canon of Christmas specials you need to watch. But hopefully, with myself as this sleigh driver, I'll be able to snow your eye. Our special begins with a man walking through a winter plain in England, reminiscing about how, as a child, he built the snowman. We are then cut to the animation style of the film, which is worth spending a segment of the video on its own because it's so great and unique. We cut to a child waking up and looking outside to find that there is a great amount of snow on the ground. He's so excited that he doesn't even put on underwear before he goes outside.
Not wearing underwear during winter? That has to feel weird.
The boy then decides to build a snowman. As you do. And later that night, the snowman comes to life and they decide to chill out in the house, and shenanigans ensue.
Your parents are asleep, Charlie. Let's skin them alive and throw their carcasses out to the snow to freeze to death.
The tomfoolery eventually leads them outside, and then they take to the sky. Wait, what the heck?
Wow, I know snow falls, but I didn't know it can fly. Elsa and Sub-Zero got nothing on this snowman.
As you can see, the main attraction here is the animation and art style. It has an aesthetic all its own, and while it looks choppy at parts, it is pretty incredible in motion. Famous film producer and current Lucasfilm president Kathleen Kennedy once said that you can take any frame from one of Hayao Miyazaki's films and it'll be presentable as a portrait of sorts, and I feel that it's appropriate to describe The Snowman in that way. It looks like a wintertime storybook come to life. It's lush and wonderfully charming in a positively childlike sort of way. While I do want to give the most legitimate praise possible for the short, it seems to have reverse Wall-E syndrome in that its second half is way better than its first half. The fiddling around the house doesn't really strike me as interesting or explicitly entertaining or funny.
Deja vu, I've just been in this place before. Higher on the street, and I know it's my time to go. Going new, and the search is a mystery. Standing on my feet, it's so hard when I try to be me.
In fact, a big criticism of the film I feel is that it doesn't really get profound rhetorically until the very end. Yeah, with images of snowmen bouncing around, dancing, and being all cutesy, it does seem childish at times. But you know what actually makes it more charming than annoying? No dialogue. Yeah, the only sound you hear is from the soundtrack. No voices or sounds from the story or characters itself. Isn't that such a breath of fresh air? It kinda sucks to see that the adage of most visual media, show, don't tell, gets so ignored in most films today, especially media aimed at a mass market or kids in general. Which sucks. I think children should be challenged and be forced to tackle hard stuff from time to time. If not in real life, in film, or any other artistic medium. I think that the notion that we need to sanitize everything for the impressionable is just foolhardy and dumb and stupid. And any other synonyms that you would like to use. Speaking of which, the soundtrack to the short is just wonderful. It's a great incorporation of a whole symphony with a large use of piano and brass. And need I mention the song that plays during the flying sequence?
We're walking in the air. We're
The short really owns its own sense of atmosphere, and I think that's the biggest thing it has going for it. It does feel, like the man said, that you are transported into a dream, where the ethereality is embraced and all physical logic is abandoned. Right until the very end, which seems fitting that, given the framing device, all good things must come to an end and cannot last forever, that some things may only exist as a faint reverie. Such is life, and such is the holidays, I guess. The short was followed up by a sequel years later, and while I haven't seen the follow-up, it— holy crap, is it a snow pupper?
Ah! It's so cute! Yoo-hoo, it's so cute! It was a puppy, it was a puppy, it was a puppy, ooh!
At the time of this recording, both films are available on DVD, so I highly suggest you pick up at least the first one. I highly, highly recommend that you give it at least one watch. Like I said, it was also released on VHS back in like the 80s and 90s, so you should be able to come across a copy.
I know that 2016 has been a weird year for me. You, us, humanity. But I want to let you know that I really do appreciate you stopping by and listening to what I have to say about a whole myriad of things. And I just want to let you know that throughout 2017, I'll be continuing to do this. And I just want to let you know again that I appreciate you stopping by every time. So I just want to say thank you, and I hope you have a wonderful holiday season, and a better year in 2017. And that you are worth it. That you are worth going through that year, full force, with whatever endeavor that you do. I'm Maximum Austin, and as always, keep being confident, and you enjoy your day. And you have a nice... And you have a nice holiday season and a happy new year.